armed to the teeth, and we are ready. Alright, so let's just put in all the items I can, because if I'm not going to use them now, I'm definitely using them later. Donald and Goofy, you can have some too. I know I'm not really focusing on what I'm putting in, mostly because I have a lot of items and it doesn't matter who holds who. They like to use the items a lot. The Mega Elixirs I am saving for when I do my final fight against Xemnas. I mean, not Xemnas! Xehanort! Not Xehanort! Ansem! Alrighty. Let's do this. We are overly prepared for this. This makes me want to watch Fantasia again. But I do like how they kept the original song in here too. Most of his attacks are either swinging at me or fire-based. What I like is how he does have a lot of blind spots, though. If we start getting too much for him, he'll blast us away with air. I want to say it's arrow gun. And when he starts getting like this, it just means that he's getting ready. He's getting serious now. Oh wow, he got serious the second time. And now he's gonna blast us away. Oh wait, hold on. Blind spot it is. Thank you, Leaf Bracer. Oh, we're already almost done. And... okay, that was way too easy. I don't even think we needed any items. Huh. Well, hopefully Donald the Goofy didn't spend too much. Three minutes. Ha! Record. And Super Glide. Alright, let's see. Let's descend further and further into hell. Oh, wait, before I forget. I'll leave the items in because there is, like, a spam of Heartless we have to face off before we actually get into the final fight. No, no AP boosts. Alright, there we go. Let's go. Unfortunately, we can't land in this area where we are. We could go there. I didn't want to go in there. We are going to descend. Stop going in there! I don't even know how. I'm not even touching it. There. Trust me when I say this, going down this way is the easiest path. Hopefully it wasn't... there we go. Let's say that's hard as hell to make. To work. To... control. God damn it, I had a word in my head and I can't remember it. But we're almost there. Now all that's left is to deal with the Heartless. Oh! Crud, okay. Everything he did was unnecessary. He did not have to lunge at me as soon as I came in. Oh, he's really weak, actually. Okay, fine. Don't die. Heal. Alright, so how this works is that there are going to be a spam of Heartless protecting this place, which is pretty much like the heart of this world, or the heart of the darkness. The more Heartless I defeat, the more pieces fall off of this. And pretty soon that'll be my way out. See? I can already see another piece falling off now. Jeez, every one of them is attacking at the same time, so it's constantly deflecting my attacks! Oh, a lot of pieces are already falling off. Not to mention, this would be a great place for later for spamming on, what was it, white mushrooms, but, you know, since I already completed all that, I guess at this point it'd be useless. So if you just want to spam for experience, this is actually the best place, because they do respawn every time you leave and come back into the area. Like we're on the last piece. Unless the piece just gets smaller and smaller every time we finish. Oh my god, they're all annoying. Strength up. This just gets more and more annoying with every hit. Oh, I think that's it. Perfect! And I have still not gone past 10 minutes. This is going a lot faster than I remember it being. Alright, let's see what's left. Final rest. So this is right before the last fight. Oh, they gave me an elixir. Dang it, stop going to Goofy. Wait, what the hell? Oh, okay. I don't know what I'm doing anymore. To save real quick. Alright, time to finish Kingdom Hearts. Huh? Don't you hear something? I hear a bug farting somewhere. Because I do call bullshit on their hearing. Don't be afraid, your heart's the mightiest weapon of all. Remember, you are the one who will open the door to the light. I don't hear nothing. Strange, that voice is so familiar. I used to think that voice was Mickey Mouse leading him in the beginning. But then I ended up being completely wrong, because later on, I kind of started believing that it was Ventus from Birth by Sleep, because his heart is still sleeping inside Sora. In fact, I still think it's his heart is the reason that the Keyblade chose Sora in general. And that Riku of the original three was the first only Keyblade Master chosen.
Is this my island?
Kairi was chosen because she has a protective light around her thanks to, oh, crud. That disappeared. Can't go that way. The ladder disappeared too. Everything's disappearing. Can't go up that way either. That dust is creeping me out.
This world has been connected.
What was that?
Tied to the darkness.
Okay.
Soon to be completely eclipsed.
Yeah, everything just fade.
There is so very much to learn.
And then the water turns black. While Sora's been gone, nobody's been taking care of the island.
One who knows nothing can understand.
There's Riku, or technically Ansem, I guess. I do like my fast glide, though. It helps speed things along. Ah, yuck, yuck.
Take a look at this tiny place. To the heart seeking freedom, this island is a prison, surrounded by water. And so this boy,
I swear to God, that voice.
Sought out to escape from his prison. He sought a way to cross over into other worlds, and he opened his heart to darkness.
That's something I'm curious about. Riku. Ansem is like three times the size of him, so was Riku like floating when he turned around? Because it never seems to be a change of size, just a change in the face.
His heart belongs again to darkness. All worlds begin in darkness, and all so end. The heart is no different. Darkness sprouts within it. It grows, consumes it. Such is its nature.
And now suddenly, Ansem can just teleport?
In the end, every heart returns to the darkness
whence it came. Like, magically teleport, not even without darkness?
You see, darkness is the heart's true essence.
That's not true!
Donald does not look like he's ready for fighting.
And sometimes, it may even give in. But I've learned that deep down there's a light that never goes out.
Insignificant fool!
So you have come this far, and still you understand nothing. Every light must fade, every heart return to darkness!
With everything that's been going on, it's confusing to see a heartless who has another heartless to back him up. Oh, already dead, are you, Donald? This was an accidental use.
Come, Guardian!
Oh, cool. And with Donald Goofy being controlled, he can be my human meat shield. This is getting easier and easier by the second. Oh, crud. Ah, can't harm me while I'm like this, can you? Didn't think this through. Oh, jeez, alright. Why did I waste a cure? But the one bad thing about doing boss fights like this, all the experience and all the stuff I gained from these boss fights, I don't get to keep. So it's like, why put them in there? Even if I were to wait till the end credits and just... why? It's like a tease. Or a foreshadow. Because it's just telling me what I'm gonna have to gain back when I finish the boss fight and go back to playing the regular game. But all in all, there's about 8 bosses in this fight, counting the one I just beat. There's Ansem. Next one is Darkseid, then Ansem again, and then a huge version of Ragnarok in Kingdom Hearts, where it's like 5 bosses right in there alone. Alright, so to save on items. Everybody good? Alright, let's go. So it's like, you don't have to worry about being an overachiever at this point, because you're not going to be able to keep everything you gain anyways. It was one of the fights that just irks me in this game. I'm spending all this time fighting all these bosses and I can't keep anything. Even in Kingdom Hearts 2, they took that away and made it a lot more sense. Don't mind my family. I am meleeing his arm! I've got him right where I want him! Now these things are a little less dangerous and a little more tedious. Or annoying. I don't know what to call them, really. Okay, forget it. Forget about trying to hit his face, I'm just gonna... stick with his hand. See? Look, now I gain max HP. Though that does serve me for the time being, it's not something I can keep later. Now I have to face against Ansem alone, which really isn't that big of a deal. His attacks are really no different. Though he does have a new ultimate attack, it's not something I have to worry about till later. Ah, you missed. There we go. Maybe if I lock on, it'll help. Again, not something I meant to do. So used to calling on Donald and Goofy. Okay, so you're gonna just spam that move again? Ah, right in the blind spot. Oh, this one! This one's actually good just to watch. He can't hit me if I keep dodge rolling. Not only that, when he does his final blast, it goes in four directions. Not all of them. So it's an easily avoidable attack if you're quick enough. See? Strength returns. Where did it go? Alright. It's a fairly easy fight. You just have to be quick. Or at least know his attack pattern. Also, I heard of some stories about some people who actually took the time to do this fight without equipping dodge roll and died immediately. Which is even stupider because you can't even glide faster than you could dodge roll. Dang it! I thought it was out of his reach. God, you're just so annoying! Die already! I hope you felt that in your face! Feel it! Feel my blade! What's long and fits in all holes? My keyblade! Now here's where things usually start getting difficult, and if you die, you do get sent right back to the beginning. So not only would it be tedious again for me to die here and do it all over again, it would take forever.
Behold the endless abyss. Within it lies the heart of all worlds. Kingdom Hearts.
Not exactly what I was expecting the first time I played this game. I was literally expecting a giant heart moon to be a planet of its own and be called Kingdom Hearts.
From those dark depths are all hearts born, even yours. Darkness.
Notice how they're standing on nothing. They're not flying yet, they're just standing on nothing. And of course, here's Ragnarok in his giant penis-shaped ship.
Already? Come on, Sora. I thought you were stronger than that.
Alright, so first is just facing off against Ansem on his own. There's not much avoiding you can do unless you were just to take the time and fly around him. There are times I don't know how he hits me. See, I don't even know who's hitting me at this point.
Welcome to darkness.
So yeah, I'm just spamming two moves, pretty much. This, what was it? The fact that this fight is in the air makes it a lot harder to be tactical about this. Now I have an endless barrage of it. Yeah, easy enough on my own, right? It's gonna be a lot easier when you get Donald and Goofy back. Oh, I wish they were dead, but you know, it's Disney. Can't get rid of them. Main characters. Main character never dies in a Disney movie. Now, in all honesty, I don't know what's going on here. I don't know if I'm like hitting his, fighting inside of him, like in his heart or something. Because after I had to clear out these guys, there is like a like a small heart floating in the distance or something of sorts that seems to be weakening him when I hit it. But if he was truly a heartless, he wouldn't have that heart, would he? See, look, I don't know what that is. Unless it's just a source of darkness or something. Usually they'll give you obstacles like this that you have to clear out of the way before you can progress further to get the rest of them. Ah, blind spot. How these things drop potions. Where did they get potions from? There we go. And I believe Goofy's in here. I was right. When there's so many of them, it just keeps deflecting, and then they can all fly, so deflecting in midair doesn't do anything for me. Oh, there we go. I wonder what was taking so long. How is there a load time between boss in the middle of a boss fight too? That's another thing I want to question. They did a lot to make this game better, especially since they fit it all on a Blu-ray disc, but they took away a lot from it too. Alright, now we gotta deal with this guy. Fairly easy. He's kind of stationary. His only attacks are just lightning. Have a better attack than this. It's not very often I heal other characters because they come back, unlike me. When I die for good. I like to overkill. I always overkill. Let's go get Donald back. Oh, they have less health in here. Either that or I'm just hitting them so much I'm not noticing. Why would I waste time on that? Another thing I kinda like but don't like at the same time about this game, they made it that only you can land the finishing blow. So you can't have Donald and Goofy do everything. Even though that would probably be a bad idea to let them do everything considering how slow they are. Alright, so we got Donald and Goofy back. Next is getting Ansem back out of his slumber. Because there's no way he's just sleeping on me in the middle of a fight. And sorry about the background noise. It's like really hot today, so we thought we'd open up the windows a bit. This is not exactly working too well. Look, I got a combo plus that I can't use, and a defense raise that I can't keep. That should get him out of his sleeping. Get out of here! Okay, so now we've got this going on. I think something is sapping away my MP. Oh, that might be what he was doing. And easy enough. Oh!
Yes!
Sorry about the interruption. Right, so sad part is I can't pause through this.
It is futile. The Keyblade alone cannot seal the door to darkness. Kingdom Hearts, fill me with the power of darkness.
What, you didn't have enough? Oh, I just noticed Kingdom Hearts is actually heart-shaped behind that door. I mean, it's hindsight, but I didn't think they were that obvious. You could barely see it.
I know now, without a doubt, Kingdom Hearts is light.
Light. What is this?
Why?
It's so bright. I should have brought my sunglasses. So though tedious, a fairly easy fight altogether. Now all they have to do is shut the doors.
Stop staring at Big Brushin.
Oh yeah. They look kind of weird, though.
I can't.
Like they're still manifesting.
Up. Come on, Sora. Together we can do it.
Okay.
And unfortunately, if you remember from earlier, it does say that one person has to be on both sides of the door. I mean, two people have to be on both sides of the door to lock Kingdom Hearts. Let alone even close it. That's if they can't. And you stop just to scream that? You keep trying. Easy enough. And that keyblade that Mickey is wielding is called Kingdom Key D. Supposedly the dark half of my kingdom key that you were given at the beginning of the game.
You can trust King Mickey.
Now, they're coming.
Donald, Goofy, thank you.
What's even weirder is that out of all the outfits Mickey has in all the games, why is it in the first one you only get that side glance of him and he's only wearing his regular outfit from Disney? Mickey gotta finesse that shit. Finally locking the doors of Kingdom Hearts for good. Let's remember all the good times we had with Riku before he went and killed himself, sacrificing himself for darkness. All the good times. All the times we just chilled like cool kids sitting on trees, knuckling around, smiling like dorks. Running in slow-mo. I like how sad they look too. Like they already know what's gonna happen.
Sora.
Like I know Sora purposely chose to stay behind, but it's weird that the worlds didn't immediately send him back to his island. Or Donald or Goofy.
I know you will.
What's even weirder though is that Destiny Island seems to be where Kingdom Hearts was located the entire time, considering the island was free-forming right there. Really, a lot of questions unanswered. Not unanswered, but never asked.
Thank you.
Every time I hear the song, it always gives me chills. I'm upset that they ever got rid of this track in the later games. Usually at the end of games I would have final thoughts on it, but I feel like I've gone over a lot of it in this, and I usually have my friend with me to help with final thoughts. But all in all, I still think it was one of the best games decided. A lot of platforming involved, considering for it was only a PS2 game, and a lot of detail. And if I were to cover every little thing that I went over in this game, we would have been here a lot longer than 26, 27 episodes. And I still have to go back and do all the secret boss fights. I haven't defeated the Phantom or Kurt Zisa or secret boss that I have yet to mention. I won't show him till I'm ready. Or the Ice Titan either, but I doubt we're ready for that one either. He's kind of OP'd in this game. Comparing their drawings, Sora was a very shitty artist. And there's no excuse, because Kairi was the same age and did even better than he did. Alright, and that is Kingdom Hearts 1. Though, I'm gonna give it some time and see if there might be anything after the end credits, but all the end credits is doing is just recapping the game images, which I felt was kind of dumb in general. So, I will wait it out and see what's after the end credits. I will be back with you guys in just a moment. Alrighty, Kingdom Hearts final mix completed. I want to know what this world is, actually. Maybe this is what Kingdom Hearts looks like while it's protecting the darkness. I mean, not protecting, keeping back the darkness.
We've got to find Riku and King Mickey.
But, where do we start looking for that there door to the light?
Or maybe this is what a Walt Disney world looks like. I mean, you have Disney Castle, but maybe this is what Walt Disney's world looks like. I like how completely still they were. They were like statues. None of them moved. You didn't even see Donald's back of his mouth move.
Hey, have you seen King Mickey? Guys, let's go.
Come on, guys, you can run faster than that. That was well overdue. Who are you smiling at? You cannot see the camera trailing you. You are the one who will open the door to the light. I still think that's Ventus. And I know we're supposed to get a secret clip because we beat it on proud mode, or hard mode, whatever they're calling the hardest mode in the game. I think it's proud mode. Ah, yes, here it is. Special secret movie, another side, another story. Oh, so they do have English translations. Good. What's going on in the realm of darkness? They completely OP'd, not OP'd, they made these characters look awesome. See, like, if we had movie clips with this kind of animation, I think we'd have a lot more Kingdom Hearts fans in the world then. And the sad part is that they're referencing Kingdom Hearts 2, but none of this ever happened in it. If anything, some movie clips like this actually happened in 358 over 2 days. But this is an awesome movie clip. And the way they transition everything. And who's that handsome devil with the blindfold? Could it be? This is a fairly long secret movie clip. 8, 7, 6, 6? Did I miss it? No, there it is. 3, 2. And then Mickey coming up in his winter coat. Oh, they're not finished. What I like how they do is when they made this Japanese version available for English, I like how they redid the animation of their mouths moving so it actually matches up with the words. I was worried that was going to be like them speaking Japanese and all you do hear is English translations over it. Because then their mouths wouldn't match up right, and for some reason it just irks me. And most animes do that, which is why I watch them all in Japanese. But I'm sidetracking. There you have it. And that was Kingdom Hearts Final Mix. Now just for the... There's something else. I think there's something else. Oh, no, that's it. I didn't defeat as many Heartless as I thought I did. 5,500 Heartless. I got killed 13 times. Attacks deflected 616. Times hit by an enemy 1,280. Not exactly bragging, right? Total item usage. Party member knockouts 212. Now that's not my fault. Well, there you have it. Kingdom Hearts Final Mix defeated. Thank you guys so much for joining me on all this. And next time I start any Kingdom Hearts, it's going to be Kingdom Hearts Rechain of Memories. Bye-bye.